Trust your first impression. Where are you? What do you see in your mind's eye?
I don't see anything.
It's all right. So we're going to go to a place that you have been before. We're going to go to the memory of one of your dreams. Or, perhaps, that dragon that you saw when you were a boy. Go ahead and begin describing this memory. Be there now.
Say, dragon.
Mm-hmm.
Or a reptilian with wings.
Mm-hmm.
Inside of the wall next to my bed.
Mm-hmm.
Sleeping.
How old do you think that this reptilian is as you look at it?
Looks young.
Mm-hmm.
Baby.
A baby. Tell me more.
Not physically there.
Mm-hmm. So I'd like for you now to do what you know how to do best. I'd like for you to allow yourself to lift yourself from this dimension. And let's go into the dimension where this baby dragon resides. So tell me how you do this.
It just happens.
Mm-hmm. So allow it to happen now. And tell me what you experience.
Darkness.
Mm-hmm. Darkness. Very good. Tell me more. Look around.
See, it's void, mm-hmm. Dark.
Mm-hmm. So we're going to now use that part of your mind that sees through the imagination. And I'd like for you now to begin filling in the spaces of that void. Let's see what's there when you use that other part, the eyes from a different dimension. What shows up? What's the first thing that you imagine is there?
Just darkness.
Very good. So even in the darkest of places, there's always something there. So we can use an instrument, perhaps a flashlight, a candle, something to light up this place. Because even in the darkness, we'll be able to light it up. And as you are using this to light up this place, I'd like for you to tell me if this place, this void, this darkness, is indoors or outdoors. How does it feel?
It's big. It's expansive.
It's expansive. Very good. Now, in this void where you are, do you feel that you have a physical body? Turn on the observer of the void and see if you have some sort of form. What do you sense?
I don't sense anything.
Mm-hmm, very good. So if you don't sense anything, then we can move through this void. It means you have no body. So I want you to go ahead and begin propelling yourself through this void. Use your thought and intention to begin moving within this void. And use that light to begin illuminating what's around you. And tell me what you're experiencing. Because the more you talk, the more you'll see.
It's just dark.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing, see anything, not even a reference of anything.
Mm-hmm. Now you know that everything is intention. So we're going to create something in that void so that you can go through. We can create a sort of portal to go through to the other side of this darkness. So I'd like for you now to use your intention and create a portal in that darkness and tell me what it looks like in your mind's eye. What do you create? What does this portal look like to you? It could be a perhaps a little wormhole or a tunnel or a door.
It's a circle.
A circle, very good. And this circle, does it have any type of perimeter around it?
See through bent. Like light bending glass.
Mm-hmm. Very good. So I'd like for you to see yourself getting closer to that circle. And on the other side of the circle will be a different reality. So allow yourself now to step through or float through that circle. And tell me what happened. What do you imagine is there?
It's not taking me anywhere.
Mm-hmm. Well, allow yourself to go. Allow yourself to create that reality. Use your mind. What do you imagine is there? Use all of your senses. You can perhaps create a beautiful vacation place. You can create a place on another planet. Perhaps the place where you visited during one of those ceremonies. What do you imagine is there in your mind's eye?
It's like I'm just being given darkness.
Mm-hmm.
I don't see anything. I just.
So let's find out who is in that darkness with you. If you're just being given darkness, let's request for one of your guides to accompany you on this journey of darkness. And this guide could show up in any shape or form. Allow yourself now to see that guide. You tell me what you experience. What's the first thing that pops into your mind?
Something's trying to come through, but I can't.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're not going to try anything. You just allow it. You're in a state of allowing, so allow this thing to pop through. What do you imagine it is? You're not going to be using your eyes, you're going to be using your other senses. Since you're in the dark, we'll be using the senses that you use when you walk into a dark room. And you just know there's something there. So what do you sense that's coming through? What does it feel like to you?
It's distortion.
Distortion, mm-hmm. Let's find out what this distortion is coming from. What does it feel like to you?
I feel like I'm blocked from everything.
You're blocked from everything? Or do you imagine that Henry's blocked? What are you keeping him from seeing? What's on the other side that Henry can't see?
There is movement here, something. There's just like every... It's like darker and lighter shades of darkness, but...
Beautiful.
There's nothing...
Mm-hmm. So I'd like for you now to connect with that knowing and find out why it is that you're being shown this darkness. Why is that? What does Henry need to see this darkness? Is this a reflection of something that he needs to see? Connect with your knowing. You'll know the answers. What is this darkness he's seeing?
Just in a void.
The void. Is Henry in a void right now? Has he put himself in a void? In his life?
There's nothing, there's no direction, there's mm-hmm. nothing.
Is that a representation of Henry's life? What is that darkness? Let's close that scene and let's go somewhere where Henry can remember. Henry used to have dreams when he was a little boy. It was a recurring nightmare on a pirate ship. I'm going to count from 5 back to 1. When I get to number 1, I want Henry to go ahead and see himself on that pirate ship. 5. Going back in time now. 4. Getting younger and younger. 3. Moving into that dream. 2. Almost there now. And 1. Be there now. Look around you. What do you remember? What do you see in your mind's eye?
Still darkness.
Mm-hmm. Allow yourself to disconnect from that darkness and allow yourself to get onto that ship. Be there now. What do you see around you? Use your memories, tap in. Tap into your memories. What's the first thing that comes up to your mind?
Old ship.
Old ship. Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
Rough seas.
Rough seas.
Dark nighttime.
Mm-hmm. Dark nighttime. What else do you see?
People. Bad people.
Mm-hmm.
Some type of slave ship or something.
A slave ship. Let's find out more. What else do you see in this place?
People tied up.
People tied up. What do these people look like? What color is their skin?
They're all white.
Mm-hmm. How are they dressed?
Dirty.
Dirty. Are they male or female?
Male. Some females, but they're just being mistreated.
Mm-hmm. Where are they tied up? Where do you see them?
Poles.
Mm-hmm. I want you to use all of your senses and your smell, your hearing. What else is going on there? Describe this place.
A wooden boat.
A wooden boat. How big is this boat?
Big.
Mm-hmm.
I'm only on one part of it.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that you have a body on this boat?
I'm not on the boat.
Where are you?
I'm seeing it.
You're seeing it. Very good. So let's see from what perspective you're seeing it. From where are you? Are you above it? Are you within it? Where do you see it from?
I'm on it.
You're on it. So if you're on this boat, you can move around it. Let's find out what's on the other side of that ship. What else do you see?
Troubles.
Troubles?
I'm having trouble seeing.
That's all right. You don't need to see. All you have to do is sense. Use that inner knowing. Let's find out what it is about this ship that's important. What's going on here? Allow yourself to go deeper into your knowing. As you go deeper and deeper, you'll just know what's happening. You're connecting with that information.
People being mistreated.
Mm-hmm.
Forced to do things.
Mm-hmm. What kind of things are they forced to do?
Work.
Mm-hmm.
Obey.
What is it about these people that affect you? What is the reason why you've been shown this over and over again? What does it have to do with the life of Henry?
Control.
Control. What kind of control?
Normalizing it.
Mm-hmm. So as Henry watches the scene, what is he receiving information about? What is the purpose?
The world thrives on control.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not controlled.
Mm-hmm. Is this a choice?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So when did Henry make this choice of not being controlled?
Never been controlled.
Mm-hmm.
They're chasing me to the ship because I don't... can't be controlled.
Mm-hmm. Was Henry one of the slaves there?
I don't know.
Let's find out. Let's find out who's chasing you.
The guy, the men that work there.
Mm-hmm.
They're chasing me because I have something. Leading them. Pulling someone with me.
Mm-hmm. Who are you pulling with you?
Some girl.
Mm-hmm. How old are you there on that ship?
I feel young.
Mm-hmm.
14. I think I'm trying to help her. They were tying up women to beams. But I get to a door, it's closed. I try to break the window. I know I'm in a dream. How does this make any sense?
I want you to allow that ego to take a little vacation and just tell me what you experience. What are you trying to break?
The glass to the door.
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't make sense because this is an old ship. How does it have glass?
Mm-hmm. I don't want you to analyze. I want you to just tell me what's happening.
I'm trying to break through a door, but I can't get there.
Mm-hmm. So what happens?
Nothing happens to me.
Mm-hmm. What do you do next?
They don't do anything to me.
Mm-hmm. Why is that?
I don't know. I don't think I'm a slave or anything.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that you work on that ship?
I don't know. I don't seem like I'm part of them.
Mm-hmm.
It just doesn't make sense while I'm there. Why I'm there?
Mm-hmm. Can you look down at yourself and see how you're dressed?
Barefooted.
Mm-hmm. What else?
Pants that are like canvas.
Pants like canvas?
Shirt.
Mm-hmm.
Young, skinny.
Mm-hmm. What does your face look like?
Just a boy.
Mm-hmm. Do you belong to any of these men on that ship?
No.
Mm-hmm.
I don't feel any connection to anybody. It's confusing. It's just confusion everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Are you creating some of this confusion?
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. Let's find out a little bit more about how you got on that ship. I want you to close that scene. And we're going to go back to the time before you got on that ship. I'm going to count from 3 back to 1 and allow yourself to be there. 3, 2, and 1. Be there now. What do you sense around you?
I just climbed in.
Mm-hmm. You just climbed in.
I think this is just the way things are.
Mm-hmm.
Not many rules. Just, I don't know anyone though.
Mm-hmm. What do you imagine you, why you were going into that ship? Were you curious or what? What was the reason?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This is, I'm harmless, they don't pay attention to me.
Mm-hmm.
But no one seems familiar. I don't know anyone here.
Mm-hmm. So what do you do when you're on that ship?
Just try to keep away from anyone seeing me.
Mm-hmm. Where do you go? So that they don't see you.
Just hide. I'm small enough, I can hide anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
It's dark. Everyone's busy. It's almost like, not really hiding, but they don't see me.
Mm-hmm. You blend in.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Are you still at the port or are you out to sea now? Look around.
The port.
Mm-hmm. So let's find out what happens next. I'd like for you to close that scene and let's now go to the scene where they find these people that they make slaves. Be there now. Where are you?
They just take people. They go to places and just take people.
Mm-hmm.
No agenda. They have a bunch of women. They're purposely trying to instill fear.
Mm-hmm.
There's just no reason they're doing it. They're just doing it.
How does that make you feel when you watch this?
Scary.
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty scary. There's no order. There's no morals, no value.
Mm-hmm. So what happens next?
Like they're sacrificing some woman.
Mm-hmm. What do they do?
She's tied up to a beam or something. I don't know why it's not happening, but it feels like they're gonna burn her.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm not seeing that. It just feels that way.
Mm-hmm.
I have no idea why.
Mm-hmm. All right. So let's close that scene and let's go to the next significant scene in that same lifetime. Be there now.
She's the same woman I was, she was the one I was running with.
Mm-hmm.
Tried to run away with her. On the boat, there's nowhere to go.
Mm-hmm.
Makes no sense.
So what do you do?
I grab her, I think I untie her. So I'm pulling her behind me running, but I'm not that smart. There's nowhere to go on a boat in the water.
Mm-hmm.
That's why they're not concerned, because they can't get away. So they just take her back.
How does that make you feel?
Helpless.
Mm-hmm.
But they don't do anything to me. It's almost as if I don't really exist, you know,
mm-hmm.
really pay me any mind. Maybe it's my age.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe I'm one of them, I don't know, I don't feel a connection.
What happens next?
someone interacts with me. Mm-hmm. I don't really even have to hide. No one interacts with me. Unless, only when I took her. Mm-hmm. Weird.
So let's see what happens. I'd like for you to close that scene. And let's move forward to the next significant event in that same lifetime. What happens? Where are you?
I'm unable to move forward.
Mm-hmm. So let's see what happens there. What's important about this time and place?
It's just evil. Everyone is just like mindless. Mm-hmm. No control. Mm-hmm. Pain and fear. I don't feel it now. I don't feel afraid. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of fear, and there's a lot of anger, and evil, and just no love anywhere. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure why I'm seeing this.
Mm-hmm. So I'd like for you now to close that scene and go to the last day of your life in that lifetime. Go to the last day.
I got stabbed there. Mm-hmm. Somebody stabbed me. Mm-hmm.
So I'd like for you now to leave that body behind. Allow your spirit to go where it needs to go. And tell me what happens. Where do you go after you leave that body? What do you see next?
Darkness.
Darkness. Now, in this darkness, was this your your lifetime? Or was it the lifetime of this boy?
This boy. Mm-hmm.
So where is this boy now? Is this boy with Henry?
No.
No.
It's not me, it wasn't me. Mm-hmm. It's like I see.
What is it?
It's like I can... It wasn't me. Mm-hmm. But I can feel what the kid was feeling. Mm-hmm.
So I'd like for you to scan your body and see if this kid is somehow associated with this body. Go ahead and begin scanning from your feet up into your head, and let's find if this boy is still here.
No.
No.
Feel like I'm
Mm-hmm. So let's find out what that boy meant in this lifetime. I'd like for you now to connect with that inner knowing. I'd like for you to go ahead and take a deep breath and allow yourself to go back down to sleep. Feel yourself going deeper and deeper to sleep. Allow that conscious mind to go on a nice little vacation. And let's go deeper to sleep. Going down. Down, down. I'd like for you to see yourself now in a beautiful garden. There's a path going through the garden. Look around. Imagine flowers, perhaps little butterflies, going from one flower to the next. You could see their wings, all the different colors. And as you continue down the path of this garden, you'll find a concrete bench in the middle of the garden. There's a waterfall behind it. You can practically feel the mist of the water. I'd like for you to go ahead and sit on that bench. Look all around you. Enjoy the sounds, the feelings, the smells of that garden. I'd like for you now to connect with your spirit guide, the one that has brought you here. I'd like for you to go ahead and see your spirit guide in whatever shape or form come up the path and tell me what you imagine it to be. What do you imagine? Take any shape or form. What's the first thing that comes to mind?
Colors.
Colors, very good. What colors do you see?
All of them.
What is it?
All of them.
All of them.
Mm-hmm. It's like a rainbow fluid liquid.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Allow that to flow towards you. Tell me how big this is.
It's everywhere.
Mm-hmm. So allow yourself to be engulfed in this color. And tell me what happens next.
Just there, it feels like it's just looking at me.
Mm-hmm. Now every color has a different vibration. Every color allows you to connect with different emotions. I'd like for you to connect with these colors and allow the connection between you and your guide, because you are part of it and it is part of you. And I'd like for you to tell me, through your guide, what was the significance of life on that pirate ship? What did Henry see there?
For a world of darkness.
Mm-hmm. Why has he chosen to live in such a world of darkness?
Not the challenges for him.
He loves the challenges?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Where did he come from before that didn't have the challenges? He's had it easy. Did he make a decision to come into this world at this time for a certain reason?
It's just experience.
It's just an experience. Very good. Can you tell me a little bit about the experiences that he's asking about? He says that he was given a dark experience during the recent ayahuasca ceremony. He saw very dark and many shadow entities, and they were feeding off of the suffering. Why did Henry see that?
It's good for him to see.
What is it?
It's good for him to see.
It's good for him to see.
He's pretty advanced in his knowing.
Mm-hmm.
But sometimes it's just needed to show it to him.
Mm-hmm.
Show him that the decisions that people make mm-hmm. can affect what attaches to them.
Mm-hmm. And this gargoyle that he kept seeing when he was younger, was this part of this experience? Or was that something else?
It's a reptilian.
It's a reptilian. So what was the reptilian doing there? Why was it there with him?
Trying to normalize him.
Hmm.
Get him accustomed to seeing reptilian.
Ah, why is that?
Make a choice.
Mm-hmm. What choice did he make?
He chose against it.
Hmm. Why were the reptilians in his life from such a young age?
He's been exposed to a lot of darkness.
Mm-hmm.
But it never changed him.
Mm-hmm. Well, he says that he's been through a lot of stuff when he was a young kid.
Nothing directly, just experiences.
Just experiences. What did he need to have all of those experiences that were pretty dramatic?
So what he chose to come in as.
Mm-hmm.
No love.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of anger.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of control. And lots of expectations for him.
Mm-hmm.
Lots of confusion.
Why would someone like Henry choose such a rough beginning?
Not many experiences here. Not many lifetimes.
Mm. How many lifetimes has Henry had on Earth? Is this one of them?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Was the boy on the pirate ship the other one?
No.
No. Was that just a projection? A story?
Just a story.
A story. So what was the other life that he had here on Earth?
Not relevant for him to know any of it.
Okay. But he's pretty much a young human soul here. Or human experience?
He's new to the human experience.
Okay. So where is he from originally? Where has he been hanging out most of his lifetimes?
He's young human Earth. Another human somewhere else.
He was another human somewhere else? A different system?
Yes.
Okay. Why did Henry choose to come to Earth at this time?
He's a healer.
He's a healer. What does he use to heal?
Just his presence.
Just his presence. Okay.
he's always been surrounded around a lot of darkness.
Mm-hmm.
No matter how dark, how bad, it doesn't bend him.
Mm-hmm.
He anchors healing energy.
So when he was in that ayahuasca ceremony, and those people were purging and he wasn't, why was that?
He didn't purge the same way. He didn't have the energy, he didn't need to purge energetically.
Mm-hmm.
He experience was below him.
Okay.
He saw right through everything.
And why is it that he saw all of these entities and they didn't bother him?
He just cast up eyes to see.
Mm-hmm. Did they see him as something else?
He's not afraid, so they can't do anything to him.
Ah, okay. So the whole thing is really, if you have fear, you'll attract.
It's like putting food out for hungry dogs.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have the food, they don't bother with you.
Okay. So when you are in a ceremony like this and you're afraid of what will happen, you've almost set an intention.
Not in a ceremony, anywhere in life.
Anywhere in life. Okay. Good.
This place was just full of a lot of pain. So it was a feeding ground.
Mm-hmm.
But this can happen anywhere.
Anywhere.
In life, it's just, we create the fear. Fear takes on a life. Once you keep feeding it, it starts small.
Mm-hmm.
Fear is created from us.
Mm-hmm.
The more you keep feeding the same fear, then it takes on a life of its own and it just needs to feed off of it, okay. Off the same fear.
Mm-hmm. So it's a vicious cycle.
It's just a different biology almost.
Mm.
They have just as much right to live. We understand that we can keep it at bay, but because we don't understand, we don't even realize it exists.
Mm-hmm.
We inadvertently feed it until it grows out of control.
So all of these light workers that are here, so powerful at this time, have they the ability to work on this fear of Earth?
Shouldn't have any fear. There's nothing to fear.
There's nothing to fear.
Fear is a creation of this reality.
Mm-hmm.
Should never have existed, but because manipulation, we create it, and then it takes on life of its own.
Mm-hmm.
It's got its own set of rules. It's an infection.
Mm-hmm. So don't feed the infection?
Sometimes you don't know it exists.
Mm-hmm.
But just because you don't know it exists doesn't mean it doesn't.
So how can we take care of this?
There's nothing to fear.
Nothing to fear. Will our mindset alone?
Yes.
Allow it to dissipate?
Yes.
Very good. Good.
Just the mere fact of knowing that fear exists as an illusionary item will help dissipate it. Henry doesn't fear much.
Mm-hmm.
He's very emotional. Having no fear with a lot of emotions can be powerful.
Mm.
He's gone through life with very few problems in his situation because he just doesn't fear.
Mm-hmm.
Not always good. But
Does he kind of detach himself from it?
He can process it pretty fast. Mm-hmm. He will fear. He will have fear initially, and then it just dissipates really quickly.
Okay.
He processes it. He processes information really fast.
Mm-hmm.
He's not completely connected to the human experience.
Mm. Well, he even says that he was able to do astral projection where he was out of his body.
I see. He gets bored easy.
Mm-hmm.
And we have to nudge him sometimes. He gets lazy.
Lazy in what way?
He can do so much. Because he knows he can, he doesn't do it.
Ah. So what was the significance of the astral projection?
He's just reverting back to docile.
Mm-hmm.
We push him out. Get him excited.
Mm-hmm.
He got really excited.
Mm-hmm.
Don't want him getting sucked into the mundane task of just doing nothing.
Mm-hmm. Well, right now he says he's stuck. He's not making any spiritual progress.
He's too hard on himself.
Hmm. What is he supposed to be doing?
Just enjoying experience.
Just enjoying the experience?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So just be.
Just be.
Mm-hmm. A lot of people aren't satisfied with that explanation of just being and enjoying the experience.
So,
like Henry, he wants to do something.
His time will come.
Mm-hmm.
He's got a long experience left.
Mm-hmm. What kind of experiences does he need to live through?
He still has shadow work to do.
Mm-hmm.
He still has insecurities. He's still lazy.
Mm.
He's gotten lazier.
Lazy in what way?
The more he knows, the more comfortable he gets. The knowledge and the information is very powerful if you understand it.
Mm-hmm.
Almost to the point that it will render your experience useless.
Mm-hmm.
He knows that. He can become the observer really easily.
Mm-hmm.
We don't want him to get too comfortable.
Mm. By comfortable, what do you mean? Because it could mean that he needs to be in more drama. What is comfortable?
He could probably use more drama.
Mm. He could use more drama?
Yes.
He's trying to separate himself from people. Disconnecting.
Yeah.
Spending more time alone.
He's had enough time alone.
Mm-hmm. So does he need to be more sociable now?
He needs to just follow his passions.
Mm-hmm.
Stop waiting around for an event. That event is already here.
Mm-hmm. So when he follows his passions, what kind of experiences does he need to get from that? Is this people issues, or getting involved with topics?
Just, he's very versatile.
Mm-hmm.
He just wants to do everything and mm-hmm. then does nothing.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to focus on one task. Put one behind him, then move on to the next.
Mm-hmm.
It takes on too much.
Okay.
drains him.
When it drains him, what can he do?
Grounding.
Grounding. By grounding, do you mean he needs to spend time outside?
Yes.
Okay. Is he not spending enough time outside?
No.
Okay.
Go to the ocean.
Go to the ocean. Okay.
It's very convenient for him. It's close.
Mm-hmm. So when he goes to the ocean, he grounds himself, and he's now ready to experience more. Is he supposed to be experiencing with people, with his family? What should he be doing?
He should come. He needs to be back in the fold.
Okay.
He's eliminated all people from his life.
Mm-hmm.
In an effort to learn more.
Mm-hmm.
He knows too much already.
Mm-hmm.
He knows more than he needs to know. He needs to bring back the stuff that he knows and back to the people.
Mm-hmm. So he needs to be in a position of the messenger of this knowledge?
Just
teacher?
Don't need to talk about it.
Hmm.
When you... the knowing shows up in your being. Just being around people.
Mm-hmm.
Being compassionate, understanding that everyone is on a different path. Helps others. Just being there.
Mm-hmm.
Being patient. He's not good with people anymore.
Mm-hmm.
He used to be. He feels disconnected from humanity.
Mm-hmm. Well, he's done that himself, hasn't he?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to have more patience. He needs to realize that the way he processes information is advanced compared to most. Can't expect a small cup to hold 2 gallons of water.
Mm-hmm.
He can hold gallons, oceans.
Mm-hmm.
But not everyone's the same. Can't lose patience because people don't have the same capacity as him.
Mm-hmm. Is there anyone else that he needs to engage with more?
He needs to find like-minded people.
Okay.
He gets bored too easy. Mm-hmm. Doesn't care to do what others do. He needs to explore.
Mm-hmm. Well, I know that he found me through social media. Is there something that he should be doing in order to find these like-minded people?
He needs to travel. He needs to get more involved.
Mm-hmm.
You put a spark back in his life. He didn't realize that there are more people that speak the same language.
Mm-hmm.
He's on the right path.
Okay, good. Now you said that you showed him that dragon in order to normalize him. And what was the initial reason for him to coming onto this world, onto Earth? What was his purpose, his whole purpose and mission?
We're going to need a lot of healers here. He's a healer where he comes from. An elder.
Mm-hmm.
He's the clan leader of a medicine wheel tribe.
He needs to do what?
He's a clan leader.
He's a clan leader.
A tribe connected to American Indians here.
Okay. So what does he need to do for his healing?
He still has more work, inner work to do with himself.
Mm-hmm.
He's on the right path. Enjoy life more. Does not enjoy life.
Mm-hmm. Get out there more.
He needs to enjoy life. He needs to just because he's aware of what's going on doesn't mean he can't enjoy life anymore.
Mm-hmm.
There's still lots of beauty here.
Mm-hmm.
It's almost as if he understands what's happening here, so he disengages because doesn't seem real to him anymore.
Mm-hmm.
But it's wrong. It's not good for him to disengage. He needs to still continue the experience.
So as this clan leader that he is, what will his clan be? Or who will they be?
His clan, he already... He's from a clan.
He is from a clan.
In the Pleiades.
In the Pleiades, okay. Is he still receiving information from that aspect of himself in the Pleiades?
No.
No.
Not necessary.
How is he connected to the Pleiades now?
It's where soul's from.
Mm-hmm, okay.
He's still there.
He's what?
He's still there.
He's still there. What does he do there?
He has a life there.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a piece of him here.
Okay. Is more of him in the Pleiades than here?
Yes.
Okay.
So much, much more.
So is that affecting him?
No.
No.
It's helped him.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't have much experience here.
Mm-hmm.
So, he doesn't have much experience with this system.
Mm-hmm.
So it doesn't affect him negatively the way it affects people that have been living life here.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't fear it because he understands that there's more.
Mm-hmm. So his purpose is to be enjoy life more.
He's just here for an experience.
For an experience.
It's not limited to anything. He can choose whatever he wants. He will do well.
He just needs to heal the planet. Help heal.
Just be there for people.
Just be there.
Just be there.
So what is this going to happen that he needs to be there for people? Is there something going to happen?
Emotional trauma.
Okay. Anybody with emotional trauma?
Lots of emotional trauma.
Mm-hmm.
When the veil is lifted, people are going to be disoriented.
Hmm.
He's going to be a lighthouse.
Okay. What will it feel like when the veil is lifted?
It's hard to explain.
Mm-hmm.
Calm. Calmness. And calmness for him. Relief for him. Madness for lots of people.
Hmm. Where does this madness come from?
People won't understand what's going on. Most people don't understand what's going on now.
Mm-hmm.
So when time comes,
mm-hmm.
all the filters are removed. It's going to be pretty shocking for people.
Mm-hmm.
So people like Henry be able to help others integrate.
Mm-hmm. Now these filters, are these the three-dimensional filters?
Yes.
Okay.
Four-dimensional filters.
Four-dimensional, okay.
Well, it's four-dimensional overlays on a three-dimensional reality.
Okay, so once the veil is lifted, we'll be able to see things, feel things, know things?
Yes.
That we can't in this dimension?
It's not that you can't.
choice.
You can. It's all choice. Mm. But because of the fourth dimensional overlays that shouldn't exist here, mm-hmm. they've been here for so long that we don't know what the reality is, what is reality and what's an overlay. Mm-hmm. It's not the fault of the people. It's distortions that were placed upon the planet. But unfortunately, the people will be disoriented when it comes off. Mm-hmm. Lots are awakening now. Lots of people are starting to get it, but even Henry is going to need some help. It's just, he's far, far, far advanced in his knowing than most mm-hmm. of the population. So are you. Mm-hmm. Conceptually, he understands what's going on. But when the veil is lifted, you're going to be in it. So the concept is different than actually experiencing it. Mm-hmm. But there are so many people that are so intertwined into the fourth dimensional overlay. They're going to suffer. Mm-hmm. So people like Henry, who can process information rather quickly, can go through the experience much faster, understand it, and help others get the same type of feeling.
Has this veil been lifted for anybody, or will it be done for the entire population?
It's being lifted slowly for some people and mm-hmm. some. Depends on where you're at. Mm-hmm. Some people can have the veil lifted, but there's no need. Okay. They're still needed here. The issue with Henry is that he's seen the other side. And because he knows that there's other stuff happening in the background, he's no longer interested in this, what's happening in 3D. Mm. He's just waiting for the curtains to go up.
Mm-hmm. When he did the ayahuasca ceremony, was he able to see into this other overlay?
He's always been able to see. Mm-hmm. Doesn't always remember.
Okay.
His diet is bad mm-hmm. at the moment. He stopped eating. Doesn't want to eat meat anymore, but he's not eating enough vegetables and fruit. Mm-hmm. The instrument needs to be tuned.
So more vegetables, more fruit?
Just needs to eat natural foods. Mm-hmm. He's seen the other side many times. He's played a lot in dream time mm-hmm. and remembers and can do it at will. Mm-hmm. He's just come along too fast, too soon. Mm-hmm. He gets bored. But he's okay. He's losing interest. He lost a little interest, but he comes in and out of it.
Mm-hmm. Now, this ability to be able to go, to know that he's in a dream or not, what's the significance of that?
His learning of that was a mistake.
Ah.
He used to urinate in his sleep. Mm-hmm. And then he realized that in his sleep he was urinating, and then he would wake up and he realized it was not real. Mm-hmm. And so he trained himself to figure out when he was dreaming and when he was real. Mm-hmm. He started practicing without knowing what he was going to unlock. And then he got good. He realized that in his dream he was going to the bathroom. He learned that dreams have no sound. Mm-hmm. So he didn't hear the urination hit the water. He stopped himself. Mm. And then he started figuring out the subtle differences between dreams and waking life. Mm. That led him to a lot of playtime. Within dreams, since he can automatically, he immediately knew when he was dreaming.
Mm-hmm.
And then he started mastering manifestation in his dreams. He started very young.
Mm-hmm.
But he got bored. He got too good too fast. He got bored. It's not something he should have learned so soon.
Mm-hmm.
But he learned it, and he played with it for years, and then he just got bored.
So it's not good for you to be doing that, then?
It's okay. He needs to just... He doesn't do it anymore. He can if he wants to.
Mm-hmm.
He seems to get bored very easily.
Mm-hmm.
Does things and he goes and he does them to full extent.
Mm-hmm.
And then he takes it too far and gets bored.
Mm-hmm.
He needs to appreciate the subtleties of life. Not go so hard at everything.
Mm-hmm. So be more gentle on his experiences?
Yeah, he tries to learn too fast. Mm-hmm. He just takes on too much information.
Mm-hmm.
And because he can learn so quickly, he could learn what people take 2 years, 5 years to learn.
Mm-hmm.
He can learn it in a couple of days.
Mm-hmm.
And just like after 5 to 10 years, people get bored, he'll take 2 to 3 months to get bored.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't really help for employment and relationships, does it?
No. Yes, there are tolerance.
Mm-hmm.
For people that are slower, he needs to understand he's just a little different.
Mm-hmm.
Have compassion. He's never had an issue with employment.
Mm-hmm.
He can do anything.
Mm-hmm.
He currently is in a job that he enjoys.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't take much out of him.
Well, what about relationships, though? Because that's a big one. We have to interact with people throughout our days. We have to have friends that we interact with or co-workers. What advice do you have to give to Henry on not shutting them out completely because they're not at his level?
He needs to have more compassion.
Mm-hmm.
He's starting to learn it. He's learning it by teaching his daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Every time he tells his daughter to have more compassion, he realizes that he needs it as well.
Mm-hmm. So he's actually teaching her what he needs to learn?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And then his daughter reminds him.
Mm-hmm.
He still has a lot of learning to do. He's still...
Mm-hmm.
Patience. His mind moves quickly.
Mm-hmm.
His thoughts are very fast all over. He needs to slow down.
Mm-hmm.
Pay attention to the subtleties
mm-hmm.
of life here on Earth.
Mm-hmm. And is there anybody in his circle of friends or family that are soul acquaintances from the Pleiades?
No.
No, he's on his own.
He came into this reality as a walk-in.
As a walk-in. When did he walk in?
A young age.
Mm-hmm. How old was he?
Right after birth.
Hmm. Why did he not choose to go through the birth experience?
It's an agreement made.
Mm-hmm.
The physical body was born premature.
Okay.
Did not line up with the original soul.
Mm-hmm.
Lined up with Henry.
Mm-hmm.
Soul decided to come in last minute.
Mm-hmm.
Not much planning.
Okay. And here he is.
And he's done well.
Okay.
Too well. Challenges. Problems don't affect him.
Mm-hmm.
He easily resolves them.
Mm-hmm.
He's a little disconnected from human emotion.
Mm-hmm. Is that a good thing?
No.
No. Does that hurt him?
It hurts his progress.
Okay.
He understands that everyone's in an experience. So at times he is a little insensitive. Mm-hmm. Knowing that they're not really going through it. Mm-hmm. But what he doesn't understand is that here, in the now, in this reality, that they are going through it. Mm-hmm. He needs to have compassion for people, patience. Everyone's at a different time in their evolution. He's a little ahead of the curve. Mm-hmm.
So he needs to allow the people to have their drama?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Not judge it?
He doesn't judge it. He just doesn't want to deal with it. Mm. He understands that everyone has their drama. He just chooses not to have it in his life. Mm-hmm. And bluntly and blatantly pushes it away. Mm-hmm. As opposed to maybe even entertaining it a little bit. Mm-hmm. Not for him, but for others. Mm-hmm. His presence can help them through their dramas.
Okay. So that's a good thing for him to kind of focus on, the fact that he doesn't need to be sucked in, but just his presence would be kind of like a light into the darkness?
Yes. Mm-hmm. He's got a drama. Mm-hmm. He just doesn't care to play it.
Okay.
He can help people just by interacting with them. Mm-hmm. He's really good at it. Mm-hmm. He's very good at seeing what others don't see. Mm-hmm. He feels what's going on. He just has a knowing. He understands what is happening behind the curtains.
So, why is it that he was brought here to this session today? What did he need to know or be reminded of?
That we all have work to do. We're here to we're here for the human experience. Enjoy it, have fun, laugh, cry, experience, be here for others, unite, don't separate yourself. Mm-hmm. It's hard for him, he's easily affected by others' mm-hmm. energy. If he's around angry people too much, he becomes angry easily. Mm-hmm. If he's around a lot of loving people, he's a sponge. Mm-hmm. He can pull himself out of it, but he can pull himself out of it consciously, but the feelings are always there. He's like a repeater. Mm-hmm. He's like an amplifier. Mm-hmm. He's always done well in every environment because he takes on the energy, disseminates it, does the best he can. Mm-hmm. He's a doppelganger.
To the other person, you mean?
To energy.
To energy, okay.
He can go in and out of any social situation, mm-hmm. any energetic situation, and become one of them, while understanding that he's doing it with intent. Mm-hmm.
So he needs to do more of that.
He should.
Good, good, good. Now, when he first started this session, he kept seeing darkness. He was in the void. What did that represent?
Firewall.
Ah.
We're blocking him from information for now.
Okay.
He's challenges, he's insatiable with information. We need to block him off. Mm-hmm. he doesn't need to know much more. Mm-hmm. He already knows enough. The more information he's given, the more it takes him away from living.
Mm. So he needs to really engage in the experience of life here on Earth.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. He came here for it. He came here to experience 3D life. Mm-hmm. And he's trying to connect to too much information out of 3D. Mm. We are pleased that he is fully awakened, but he still needs to, he still has to live here. He gets information and he runs with it, and he forgets that he's living a 3D life.
Mm-hmm. How much longer are we going to be living this 3D life before this veil is lifted?
Not much longer.
Mm. Are we talking weeks, months, years?
How about you know the answer to that? It's not that easy to mm-hmm. disseminate here.
Yes.
It's fluid.
It's fluid.
Time here exists very strangely.
Mm-hmm.
Outside of here, it's already happening.
Mm-hmm.
The trickle-down effect is what we're looking at now.
Okay.
The last few months have been big here.
Mm-hmm.
Big strides have been made.
Mm-hmm.
The amount of people awakening is exponentially growing. But it's, to some, it'll be a blatant awakening. It'll be a blatant
mm-hmm.
event for others. It'll take time.
Mm-hmm.
They won't even see it.
Mm.
There's too many distractions in this reality.
Mm-hmm.
Too many distortions with electronics.
Mm.
Information, too much information, mm-hmm. distortion. People need to step away from the distortions to feel what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
Too much manipulation. But it'll all end soon. There's going to be a major purge.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's going to be taken down.
Uh-oh. What does that mean? What kind of things will be taken down?
The control grid
mm-hmm.
is going to be fried. People are going to all of a sudden realize that something's changed. It's already on its way.
Mm-hmm. Is this the control grid that pretty much controls the fear and the manipulation of people?
It controls what people see and feel.
Mm-hmm.
It controls behavior.
Mm.
It controls the information that dominates most people's minds.
Mm-hmm.
It's the disconnect. People are disconnected to
mm-hmm.
source reality.
Is this grid a artificial intelligence grid?
Partially.
Mm-hmm.
It's technology, but not the way we see it here.
Hmm.
The technology, that's the old technology
mm-hmm.
that was placed here
hmm.
a long time ago.
So this control grid, does it affect the way we think?
Absolutely.
Okay. So the way that you process your thoughts, for example, would that be part of that? Would it be tapping into?
It's hard to explain.
Mm-hmm.
Some people, because of trauma,
mm-hmm.
are more plugged in mm-hmm. to this grid.
Okay.
Others that are awakened choose not to be a part of it, and so they're not a part of it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And some fall in really choice. If everyone chose to be done with it, it would all go away in a nanosecond. But because the majority of the population doesn't see it, they choose to engage this grid. It's the only thing that's holding it up.
Our own consciousness.
It's our ability to create. They use that ability against us. Because we are creators. And we don't know it. As in the mass population. Think about this. If everyone knew that their thoughts create reality, if everyone truly knew it, and everyone aligned their thoughts, reality would shift in a nanosecond. Most people don't believe that they create anything. They believe that they are just here by coincidence to survive, no power, just a part of this system. So they're disempowered. But that thought is creating the disempowerment. So when you have the majority of the population feeling that they're just random life forms, lucky to be here, that creation is the prison. That is the prison we live in, is what we believe. If everyone believed what, for example, Henry and Alba believe, and many other people believe, it's a collective consciousness that creates the collective reality. It's also one of the issues with Henry. He knows what's really happening. He tries to disconnect from the reality, but there's a balance that he needs to be a part of it. Others are asleep to the point where they believe what's already been created, so they reinforce it. It's like putting border on an old wall. But eventually, the managers of the system will be eliminated, and the system will just crumble.
That's going to be interesting.
It's going to be amazing.
Yeah. Well, I enjoy manifesting myself. Imagine everybody else manifesting.
Imagine everyone manifesting together.
That'd be cool.
It is one of the gifts of humanity. They are creators.
And it's so much fun.
It's going to get better.
Oh, that sounds good.
Yeah.
Is there anything else that you wanted to tell Henry today? You've got so much information for him.
Be patient. Be patient with yourself. Be patient with others. Have fun.
Wonderful. Are we complete today?
Yes.
Thank you very much. All over.
Oh, God.
Wow. That was an experience.
Oh, I felt like I was being scolded.
Oh, just a tad. Just a tad. Let me put some shungite in your hand so you can ground yourself.
Oh, so weird.
I got the other selenite.
Okay.
Is this one? You got the other one?
Trinket.
Very good. So tell me what you felt besides being scolded.
Well, so I remember what... That was weird.
You hit a firewall.
Well, what's funny is...
That's a good explanation for it.
While I was talking,
yes,
I don't even know how to explain it. While I was talking, I was getting other information, so I was able to engage in what it was being said,
yes,
and engage what I was being fed.
Yeah, isn't that interesting? Other people say have said that to me too.
It's weird.
That you're getting a lot more information.
Tons.
More information. It's what you're supposed to be saying, but the next time, it's actually more is coming in.
A lot more. It's almost like like I split into two.
Mm-hmm.
And giving you information.
Yes.
And then getting answers within.
Mm-hmm.
And I felt like I was being scolded. Because I was trying to force, like, why am I, like, at a standstill?
Yeah.
And they're like, it's enough. Enough is enough.
Yeah.
Live life.
Yeah.
Like,
start enjoying yourself. Get out on the beach. Live life as a human.
Mm-hmm.
You're not in the Pleiades. You're here.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're on vacation, enjoy your vacation.
Oh, well, it was, they were not letting me through. It was just, the blackness was, yeah, you're going nowhere.
That's something.
I was so frustrated. It was like, enough.
But you got all the information.
Yeah. Well.
And then some.
Well, yeah, I got a lot of guidance there.
Yeah.
Wow.